to organize and lead community activist organizations. We work within the immigrant community here in Wayne County, mostly in SOTUS, but in generally in the full county area. Here in Western New York, the situation is distinctly different than downstate. It is dangerous for any Hispanic to walk the streets or to drive the streets or to live in this community. There has been a change in the migrant labor pool in this community for the past 40 years. But still, the majority of the population who are working in our fields and orchards are Mexicans.
Yo vine, la verdad, no sé exactamente qué año entré, porque, pero tengo 4 años aquí. Yo he trabajado, yo siempre he estado trabajando en el campo. Llegué a Florida, trabajé en una empacadora. Ahora he estado trabajando en el campo. Bueno, yo nunca habíamos tenido problemas. Ya cuando regresamos, pues había un retén. Entonces nos pararon y nos dijeron que si traíamos una identificación. Ellos no estaban preguntando que si traíamos licencia, sino que si éramos legal en este país. Entonces pues nosotros le dijimos que no, y ellos nos dijeron, muestren su licencia, dice. Y pues nosotros, como no teníamos, entonces nos dijeron, hágase a un lado, nos quitaron la llave del carro. A mí me llevaron, a mi esposo, a mi bebé. Pues lo trataron como un delincuente. Lo esposaron. Le pusieron, le digo, pues no les va a hacer nada. ¿Por qué? Porque él nunca ha matado a nadie. Él no es malo. Al contrario, es una persona muy buena. Pero ellos nunca piensan eso. Pues ni porque yo tenía a mi bebé nos dejaron salir. O a mí me dejaron salir, pero sí tengo que reportarme siempre con inmigración.
¿Tienes un brazalete?
Sí.
¿Lo tienes puesto
sí,
ahora?
Sí, lo tengo puesto.
¿No puedes, puedo enseñar el brazalete?
Sí, ¿cómo no?
Can you take a picture of the brazalete? Y así es que te... ¿Dónde te estás?
Sí. Pues aunque no quisiera yo ir, estamos en manos de migración, pues ya nada más nos queda esperar hasta cuando nos manden para México. Bueno, pues... Sí, sueño muchas cosas. Muchas cosas. Primero, a veces yo no me quisiera ir para México, porque me gusta mucho este país. Tengo una vida mejor. Ahora pues tengo mi niña, mi familia. Tengo trabajo, pues no le puedo pedir nada más a la vida más que salud. Es lo único que yo le puedo pedir. Y pues tengo tantas cosas. Todo el mundo sueña tantas cosas. Yo lo que más quisiera es quedarme, no por mucho tiempo tampoco, porque tengo una familia en México y también los extraño.
You know, you go into a grocery store and you ask somebody, where'd your groceries come from? And around here they'll say they came from Danny Wegman, Wegman's grocery store. Whereas in fact, their groceries came from Jose. And not just Jose, but Jose's wife, Juana. It's Jose and Juana who are growing the fruits and vegetables. And yet, we don't recognize them because we don't see them. We don't understand that they're humans because we don't see them. We don't hear them. You might ask me why I feel, as a U.S. citizen, the plight of the migrant farm worker is important. I can only answer you that on multiple levels. First of all, every human being has human rights. And if you can't accept that, You have to accept the constitutionality of everybody living in this country. Each person who walks on the street, each person who lives in a house, each person who lives in a car, each person who breathes the air in this country has constitutional rights. Now, if you can't accept that, then you have to accept the fact that somebody has to supply the food that you eat. And you have to accept the fact that you yourself aren't going out in the fields and picking it. And you have to accept the fact that your neighbors are not going to go out in the field and pick it. So somebody has to do it. We've got an economy that's dependent on the rest of the world for our oil, for all of our goods, including our food supply. So for our food supply to be safe, we have to have somebody here in this country picking that food. If I'm not going to pick it as a U.S. citizen, and I know you as a U.S. citizen are not going to pick it, somebody has to do it. Somebody has to take the responsibility to do that, and someone, like the people that are doing it, have to take pride in what they're doing to do it right, and they do that. So, you know, you ask me, why as a U.S. citizen this is important to me? I guess the biggest thing I can say is, as a physician, I can't drive down the road and drive by a car accident and pull over and help somebody. In the same token, if I see somebody else in trouble for no reason, but for the fact they came to this country to protect their family, then I have to pull over to the side of the road to help them. And one of these days, the rest of the citizens of this country are going to listen to citizens like me and understand that.
The hurricane blows, brings a hard rain. When the blue sky breaks, feels like the world's gonna change. We'll start caring for each other, like Jesus said that we might. I'm a jack of all trades, we'll be alright.